U.S. senators join calls for the immediate release of Philippine Senator Laila de Lima as she marks her fifth year in jail. In a statement, U.S. Senators Edward Markey and Dick Durbin and Patrick Leahy expressed their support for de Lima, a staunch critic of President Rodrigo Duterte. They believe she was wrongfully imprisoned and that the drug charges against her are politically motivated. Before her arrest on February 24, 2017, de Lima had spent a decade investigating the so-called death squad killings or Davao death squad killings allegedly orchestrated by Duterte during his time as Davao City Mayor. President Rodrigo Duterte gives honor to the people behind the EDSA People Power Revolution as the country marks its 36th anniversary today. In his message, the chief executive emphasized how unity played a crucial role in regaining the country's democracy. Duterte also calling on the public to emulate the example of the heroes of people power. Vice President Leni Robredo emphasizing how the spirit of EDSA is still alive. She says it can be seen in the people who are giving public service and everyone showing compassion to their fellow Filipinos. And the Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines, or CBCP, reminds the public to remember the lessons learned from that historic day. That includes unity and peace, which they believe should not be marred with any political color. The failure of the country's education system to teach the young generation about the lessons of people power being blamed for the return of the Marcosists to power. For Filipino historian Xiao Chua, he believes people have also changed their views about those dark times, largely because of the disappointing years that followed it.
It's a people power revolution. We always equate it with the restoration of democracy. But that democracy, of course, was hijacked by the elite. The judicial system was hijacked by them. The electoral system was hijacked by them. The political system was hijacked by them. And so people were frustrated that the crimes, the problems, I mean, of that EDSA, you know, we felt that EDSA will solve or democracy will solve were not solved. Although people and our leaders tried.
The dictator's son and name, Ferdinand Marcos Jr., is the frontrunner in pre-election presidential polls. It's something martial law victims find hard to accept.
Kung mananalo si Marcos Jr., it means goodbye to the attempts to recover the vast ill-gotten wealth that the Marcoses stole from the people. The story of EDSA must be told now at dapat sanang maintindihan ng mga kabataan more than ever because it is what in one broad stroke debunks the whole counterfeit narrative of the Marcoses who are now in their final assault on truth and justice and history as they try to reclaim Malacañang.
The son of slain Antique Governor Evelio Javier also denouncing the possible return of the Marcoses to Malacañang. Evelio Javier was killed weeks before the 1986 EDSA revolt by men who were allegedly under orders from an ally of Ferdinand Marcos Sr. 36 years later, his son hopes the deaths of his father and other martial law victims were not in vain.
When my father died, the people who were leading the fight against Marcos said, may we show your father's body around Manila to show what they've done. And we were still processing our grief, but we said, yes, this has to happen. It is once again a threat to our democracy. Behind him are all the people who like to do things to destroy democracy so they can make money, be in power, act like kings. It's not just about Marcos. It's about all the people that he brings who are expecting their golden age of whatever they did to destroy this country for their own benefit.
Earlier this week, Marcos was supposed to hold a campaign sortie in that same area where the late Governor Javier was gunned down, but the Marcos camp postponed it following strong objection by residents.
There's nothing legally wrong with doing your campaigns anywhere, but it's also a question of delicadeza and basic morality. I mean, if you kill somebody and then you hold a rally right on the spot, I don't know what that says about you, your morals, or you as a person.